Hi guys, Goffy here and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are trying out something a little bit different. If you know me or you've been here before, you'll know that I absolutely love the 28mm and 50mm focal length. If I put those two lenses into my kit bag, for me, that's pretty much all I could ever need. However, having said that, I've never really shot anything wider than 28. So in today's video, we're trying out a 21mm Elmarit. Is it just the fact that I've never tried it and therefore don't know that I want it? Or is there a good reason for not using a 21mm lens? Today's video, that is what we're gonna be looking at. Now, I haven't actually bought this 21mm Elmarit. This has been lent to me by the team over at West Yorkshire Cameras. If you do not know who they are, definitely check them out. They sell a lot of used film photography gear and also Leica gear as well. And the best thing about them, my favorite thing, is they have a really refreshing and down-to-earth grading system. You all know the websites that I mean when I say they're rating things as EXC plus, and that means it only just works. Instead, West Yorkshire Cameras actually use terms like ugly to describe some of their lenses. It's really refreshing to see a down-to-earth grading system, and that's one of the things I love about them, as well as their absolutely killer stock. Go and check them out if you don't know who they are. But for the rest of this video, we are going to be trying out this 21mm lens. I'm excited to give it a go. Like I said, never really shot 21mm before, and we are going to be hitting some of the limitations of using a rangefinder camera. So what lens was it that I actually had? It was the 21mm Elmarit f2.8 pre-aspherical. The model number for it, I'm pretty sure, is 11134. Being pre-aspherical, that generally means in Leica terms that it's going to be one that was made for film. And this is definitely the case, as this lens came out in 1980 and stopped production in 1997. So it is a pretty old lens. But because it's old, that doesn't mean it's bad. Leica lenses have always felt pretty nice, and this was no exception. Nice clicky aperture ring, nice firm focus throw, and the focus throw was pretty normal as well, and it did have a finger tab, which is something that I absolutely love having. The filter thread of this lens is surprisingly large, partly because the actual front element protrudes quite a lot, so it looks like they've had to kind of extrude the outside of the lens and then put the filter thread right in the edge, which for a Leica lens means it has a pretty chunky filter thread of 60mm. Now, the lens cap that this lens came with was pretty terrible. A lot of Leica lenses from the 80s tend to have terrible, terrible lens hoods and end caps. So I actually found myself using was a Fujifilm lens cap. I know it looks a bit ridiculous throughout some of the clips in this video, but it worked and it wasn't coming off like the original was. So it was something that I decided was more than worthwhile using. So then what were my first impressions of actually using it rather than just holding it? Now, the first thing that I thought when I put this lens on my camera was, whoa, that is wide. I'm someone who shoots a lot of 28mm. I maybe naively thought the difference between 28mm and 21mm was gonna be, oh, it's just a bit wider. The reality is it feels a lot wider. And I think this stuck with me even 3 weeks in that I really struggled to frame things in my mind at 21mm. It was only when I looked at the LCD and actually at a scene, I realized just how wide 21mm is. I'd see something, be like, I wanna shoot that. And then I'd find myself still having to walk forward to frame it up. Visualizing 21mm was something I really struggled with. And to be honest with you, I don't think I ever really got over it. And I still struggle with it a little bit now. The other thing as well that stood out straight away was taking a picture of something up nice and close. I'll frequently take a picture of like the food we're eating or the beers we're drinking, but a 21mm and 70 centimeters, things feel very far away and it felt really weird. I do think there is something really appealing about using the monochrome camera along with this 21mm. I think it's with 21mm because the field of view is so wide, frequently with color, you'll get so many kind of mismatches of color. It's quite hard to frame things, I think, that are colorful on a 21mm. But when you take the color away and remove it as a distraction, the monochrome sensor along with a 21mm actually go pretty well hand in hand. Because there's no color in it, I think it's just a little bit easier to take it in visually when you're looking at the images. Maybe it's just me, but I definitely felt like there was something kind of special about combining black and white images along with the 21mm as well. Now on this pub walk, we took one of my favorite images of monochrome month. It's this one here with the tree. Now this is an image that I'd never have been able to get if I didn't have a 21mm lens with me. And I really like the way it kind of makes the tree feel imposing. It's really hard to describe, but if this wasn't a 21mm, it just wouldn't look the same. So this is one of my favorite images, and I think, to be honest, one of my favorite images from this month of shooting monochrome as a whole. I think the other thing as well, and it kind of links into the monochrome with the 21mm, is the fact that if you're taking landscape images, you basically have to have the sky in it. 21mm is so wide that you can't really frame something up without having the sky in it. And I found, especially on this walk again to the pub, that with all of the clouds up in the sky, even though I couldn't use these color filters and I'd have liked to, I was able to tweak them in Lightroom to really bring out the clouds. And again, with the monochrome images, I just really like how they looked. There was just something about it. Sometimes it's hard to describe. Combining the 21mm and some black and white images, it just felt like a match made in heaven. Now, one of the bigger issues of shooting 21mm on a Leica camera is the fact that the rangefinder doesn't have a wide enough field of view. On cameras like the M10 monochrome, my M11, most Leica cameras will have a 28mm frame line, but to see that, you really do have to push your eye right up to the rangefinder. So 21mm, absolutely no chance. Now, you do have a few options. Option one is you use the VisoFlex, which if you're using a digital M is a pretty good option. I thought I was gonna do this, but the reality was I basically never did. Instead, I just found myself using the LCD. Now, I think there was a reason for that. With the VisoFlex, I really like using it on things like my 50mm and another lens that I've just picked up for focusing. I'm not really using it for framing, I'm using it for focusing. And if you're using a 21mm lens and you're shooting at like f5.6 or f8, everything's in focus anyway, so it's more about framing. And for framing, I'm more than happy to use the LCD. Now, if you're using a film M, that's not really an option either way, and you might find yourself wanting to pick up a little 21mm viewfinder that attaches to the hot shoe instead. Performance-wise, I found this lens to be very good, way better than I was expecting, to be honest. Knowing this lens was pre-aspherical and pretty old and made for film, I was expecting to see some softness and it not to perform like most Leica lenses do. However, that just wasn't the case. Shooting pictures of like this sign f2.8, center sharpness is really good. The corners definitely aren't great at f2.8, but what I was very surprised with is the fact that you can see some depth of field at play here. I was expecting everything to just look always in focus, but at a reasonably close distance, at f2.8, you can see some out of focus elements, which is something that I actually quite like. By the time you stop down to something like f4, f5.6, f8, things look pretty sharp across the entire frame. I did find that the extreme corners were never really perfect, even at like f5.6 and f8, more than good enough for me. This was a lens that performed way better than I was expecting. Something to watch out for as well, if you do go older than this, so you want to shoot a 21mm lens, but the generation before, I do think you run into a lot of problems on digital. So definitely watch out and do your research if you're going older than this lens. But this one, absolutely fine. So then, 21mm, is it for me? I think I've come to the conclusion that it's not. And the reason for that is it's just not versatile enough. And I've found over time that if a lens isn't versatile enough, I just don't take it out with me. So in the few occasions where I really do want to shoot 21mm, I just know I won't have the lens with me and it'll be still at home because I've taken something else instead. So for that reason, the 21mm is not going to be staying and I will be sending it back to West Yorkshire Cameras. And thank you to the team for letting me try it out for a few weeks. Now, one thing I've really enjoyed shooting 21mm, and it kind of goes for the monochrome in general as well, is how much fun it has brought to locations I've been to a lot. I showed you that image of the tree earlier. I have walked past this tree maybe 50 to 100 times in my life, and I've never once seen it the way I saw it on that day. And I found this with the monochrome camera as well. Just having monochrome only images in places I've already been seems to give them this new lease of life and makes me enjoy photography in these locations. And yeah, the 21mm definitely played into that. I had a lot of fun using it, even if I know ultimately it's not for me as I wouldn't use it. But if you've got any questions about anything you've seen in today's video, then let me know. Now, I have a really cool trip coming up tomorrow. Tomorrow, we fly out to somewhere that I cannot wait to photograph. So if you want to see that, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button if you want to see the trip that I've got coming up over the next couple of days. Thank you for watching, guys, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.